Righty-tighty-tie. Righty-tighty-tie. Oh, hello. Dear stars, we say. Life's little pleasures here. Oh, let me introduce myself. I'm Dewi. Some of you might know me as David. Or Saint David, even. Yes, Dewi Sant, the patron saint. It's quite a responsibility, you know. Being the main saint, the national saint. Some people call me the top dog of saints, yes. But you can just call me Dewi. Now, look at my wonderful collection of rocks here. They're all very, very old, you know. They're older than me, and I'm 1,500 years old. And every one of these stones or rocks means something very special to me. Take this stone, for instance. I call this stone Non's Stone because it comes from a very important place in my history, a place called Capel Non in Pembrokeshire. I was born in a raging storm on the cliffs of Pembrokeshire, in the wind and rain, thunder and lightning. Phew, that was dramatic, wasn't it? My mother's name was Non, and that's why today there is a chapel on the cliffs of Pembrokeshire called Capel Non, you see. She was the daughter of a local nobleman, and my father was the son of the King of Ceredigion, so I have royal blood, you see. And not that things like that are important at all, of course. Non's Stone, to remember my birth in the year 512. Oh. Now then, this is Rhugyfarch Stone. You see, a man called Rhugyfarch was the bishop of St. David's in the year 1094. And he decided to write my history so that you, the people of Wales, could know everything about me. And he wrote my history in Latin, yes, in something called the Vita Davidis. We call it Bichef Dewi in Welsh, or the Life of David. Here it is. Ah, Hen Venue Church, outside the lovely town of Aberaeron in Ceredigion. Now then, this is where the old monk Paulinus taught me how to become a monk, you see. Yes, even a saint has to study. Deus lux mea est. Oh, I was very fond of the old monk Paulinus, but his eyesight was very bad, and it made me very sad to see him trying to read and failing. And one day, Paulinus awoke, and he was totally blind. Well, he fell down on his knees and prayed to God. O Lord, return my eyesight so that I can serve you to the best of my ability on earth. And I felt this sudden strength within me. And I laid my hands on Paulinus's head and my thumbs gently on his eyelids. And Paulinus fell back. And then, with a heavenly smile, he rose to his feet and said, "Praise be to God, I can see you once more." And of course it was indeed all God's work. I was simply his messenger on earth, you see. But it does help a little bit, if you want to be known as a saint, that you can work miracles. Ah, yes, Paulinus's stone, which reminds me that God can give you great strength when you need it. Well, I travelled all over Wales, preaching the word of God. And I travelled a great deal of Europe too. Ah, tear there we, St. David's, my cathedral. But you see, back in my days, this glorious cathedral wasn't there. But it was me who established the abbey. The ruins still stand behind the cathedral. And this little smooth, simple stone reminds me of the abbey at St. David's. Now, by the year 550, I had been made the Archbishop of Wales. Oh, such a responsible job. And my mind was full of heavy burdens, but it was important that I still kept to the simple life. And that's why I ate only bread and herbs and drank only water. Yes, it'd be difficult for you to do that today with your chocolate and your ice cream and your pizzas. I spent most of my day praying to God. And that was quite easy, really, because God was my best mate, you see. One of the famous stories that's often told about me is the one about the sermon in Llan Ddewi Brefi. Yes, a little village with its church named after me, Llan Ddewi, by the River Brefi, you see. Well, when I arrived there after a long walk, there were hundreds, if not thousands, of people awaiting me. And I started on my sermon. "Greetings," I said. "May God be with you." But before I'd even started, someone at the back was shouting, "I can't hear you!" Someone else was shouting, "I can't see you!" Well, as you know, I've got quite a loud voice, and so I spoke even louder. "Greetings! God be with you!" No, they were still shouting, "I can't see you still! I can't hear you either!" That's when I received a message from God. He told me to place a handkerchief under my feet. So that's what I did. I stood on the handkerchief, and as soon as I did that, the ground below me began to rise, and suddenly I was standing on a hill, and everybody could see me, and even when I whispered, everybody could hear me, and that's when God sent a white dove that landed on my shoulder. A message that he was blessing my sermon at Llan Ddewi Brefi. It was a miracle. Do you remember Rhugyfarch and his famous book about me, Vita Davidis? Well, according to Rhugyfarch, I died in the year 589. And I was buried here in the abbey at St. David. Rhugyfarch also mentions my last sermon on earth, when I said to the people, "Be joyous, keep the faith, do the little things you've heard and seen me do." Yes, the little simple things, you see, they're so important. I wonder what little simple thing you'll do today that'll please God. Oh, talking about the small things, this is the saint stone. A stone that was collected in the year 1120, when the Pope officially declared that I, David, was a saint. Well, the patron saint of Wales. And today in Wales, what do you do on Dydd Gŵyl Dewi? Yes, St. David's Day. Some of you might dress up, wave your dry goch, the flag of Wales. Oh, some of you might eat bara brith and cowl and sing in eistedd fodau. Whatever you do, wherever you are in the world, you celebrate your Welshness and the fact that you are Cymraeg. But do remember, whatever you do, every day in your lives, do those little, simple things for me. Well, there we are. You've heard a little of my story. Well, I can't reveal everything to you. After all, some parts of a saint's life have to remain a mystery, you see. But I hope you enjoy your St. David's Day. And remember now, do those little simple things. How about making a flag, your country's flag, and wave it proudly on March the 1st? Yes, the day of your patron saint.